So now what I do is I start at the corner, because what's going to happen is if it's too tight, I can cut it at the corner and extend this up here. Because I found out with the first one, it was a rigid line all the way around. It was a rigid line. And every time I put it on, I got to be careful because it's kind of tight and I'm putting it on. But if I cut this, it's going to leave space for me to slide it on easily. So I'm going to put the hem, I'm going to start the hem here at the corner. So in case this is too tight. The other one wasn't too tight. It's just I feel it when I'm trying to put it on. And it's kind of, it's snug and I'm trying to pull it over my belly and stuff and over my back when I'm trying to pull it on. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start at the corner here. So just in case I want to cut this and extend this, the span. Actually, I should just go ahead and just switch this around. That's the way it's designed, you know. Now, the other one, it didn't have a backing on it. This one, I'm surprised it has a backing. So I'm going to have to actually, in addition to rolling this out, I'm going to have to take this backing off, which is kind of cool because it's twice as thick as the first one that I tried. Now, this has scotch tape on it because they didn't want it to come apart. So I'm thinking, I don't know, maybe I should just leave that on there. I'm going to leave this scotch tape on there. Okay. Here's the first hem. I see the fringes here are kind of bent because they were inside the plastic bag for a couple of days. So I'm trying to straighten them out so they don't get caught under the adhesive. Yeah, that's what you might want to do too if they get a little bent. You don't want one of them getting underneath that adhesive. Now this is good doing, because at first I was going to try and double it by putting the blue ribbon and the fringe on at the same time and iron them all at once. But when I'm sitting here, I'm flattening out that fringe here, so it makes it a much more solid bond when I put the ribbon, the blue ribbon, across the ironed fringe part. See, that makes it a stronger bond because it's already ironed. I apologize for the darkness here. It's a little dark, but I don't see a flash thing here. I could put the flash on. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open some windows. That add a little bit more light to it. Yeah, I did add a little bit more light. Okay, so now I'm gonna finish lining this up. Now again, I'm doing this for the brothers who really want to start, who really is sincere about following God's commandments and statutes, okay? Because if you do believe in the Bible, you believe in God, or our Lord and Savior. Yeah, I got off a little bit over here. Right, straighten it out at the end. Don't get me wrong, I'm not trying to take dollars away from those sisters and brothers who are out there actually manufacturing these, okay, but then who knows who's manufacturing these, you know, it could be, who knows, Esau could be manufacturing these to take advantage of us, but to show the initiative to God, to show that you're willing to put in the work. This, I think, is a little bit more substantial. Now, what I ordered was 1 yard and 8 inches. So actually 1 yard and 8 inches would work fine. See, and it went from corner to corner. So if I wanted to split this here, I could split this up the middle here so that I would get more room if the shirt's not. I just pull this up and split it here, and it's already glued, so it'll stay glued once I split it. I'm going to split it right at the sleeve corner to keep it more elasticity when it stretches, it goes on. Okay, now that's the completion of the fringe. And now I'm gonna go with the ribbon. I'm just gonna continue to go around. Now, here's the ribbon. Oops, I dropped my glue. And it unraveled, of course. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and rewind this back up. Ultimately, I think it fell because of this excess paper here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tuck it under this last one, just a wee bit. I might double it. Yeah, I'm going to double it. Give it more adhesive strength. Start it right underneath this old one, and then put the ribbon underneath this as well, because I'm gonna go under, I'm gonna go over it when I come around. I don't know, I think I could do better from the other side. I'm pulling it off. Now the ribbon seems to be a little bit crooked, so I've got to try and bend it straight. Okay. Now, it's got the first one on there, the first section of blue. So now I'm just going to rotate it. So this is the problem with this cheap $14 iron. The padding and the and the corners of this fabric is showing up when I try to rotate it. That's what I get for trying to save a couple of dollars. The one for $23 had a heavier cushion on it, heavier cushion and a heavier elastic band around it, which would have made it easier to flip this around like I'm trying to do. So instead of sliding it, I gotta pick this thing up now and carry it over. As you see, it's going pretty smoothly so far. So far, so good. So I'm going to have to pick this up, lay it over, and then pick that one up and lay it over that one because I got the cheap iron board. Pick it up, lay it over. Pick it up, lay it over. I'm down to the end. See, I just broke off the adhesive. Not sure if I should have done that so soon, but as you see him right here at the end where the tape is, and I left the tape on there. Okay, now I'm here at the bottom. So now I'm gonna cut.